Good morning students, welcome to our maths class. Today we'll be continuing the last topic of chapter number 5, that is the factors and multiples. Today I will be discussing divisibility rule. So one natural number is said to be divisible by another number if the remainder it comes zero. So we'll be learning today the certain rules that make us easier to find out whether the given number it is divisible or not. So what are these rules? Let us study now. A number is divisible to check whether a number is divisible. We have to check whether a number is divisible by 2. We have to check whether a given number is divisible by 2 or not. What is the rule to check whether a given number is divisible by 2 or not? The rule for it is, if the number is even, that is the ones digit is 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8. What is the rule? It says if at once digit even number is there, what are the even numbers? The even numbers are 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. These are the even number. So if at once place this even number is there, then the given number is divisible by 2. Let us take an example. Here I am taking an example to check whether this number is divisible by 2 or not. 3, 6, 0. I have taken a number 3, 6, 0. I have to check without dividing. Without dividing, by the rule itself, we have to check whether 360 is divisible by 2 or not. At ones place, what number is there? At ones place, here 0 is there at the ones place, 0 is there, so 0 is the even number. So 360 is divisible by 2 because at the ones place 0 is there. So this number is divisible by the 2. Let us take another example. If I take some larger number, like if I take 5463. I have taken this number. Now, without dividing, I have to check whether this number is divisible by 2 or not. Within minutes, I can find out whether this number is divisible by 2 or not. See, at the ones place, 3 is there. 3, it is the odd number. So, this number is not divisible by 2. Let us take another example. I am taking 6842. I have to check whether this number is divisible by 2 or not. See, at the ones place, 2 is there, 2 is the even number, so this number is divisible by 2. So this was the divisibility we have checked for the number 2. Let us do for the next number, that is 3. Let us do for the another number 3. We have to check the divisibility of 3. How to check the divisibility of the 3? If the sum of the digits is divisible by 3. If the sum of digits is divisible by 3, then the number is divisible by the 3. Let us take an example. First, let us take the example 360. We have to check whether the 360 is divisible by 3 or not. We have to add this 3 number. That is 3 plus 6 plus 0. 3 plus 6 is 9. So here it comes 9. Now 9, it is divisible by 3. So this number is divisible by 3. Let us take this example that I have taken here. 5, 4, 6, 3. You have to add this 3 number, that is 5 plus 4 plus 3 plus 6. You have to add this 4 numbers. If you add this 3 number, you will be getting 18. 5 plus 4, 9. 9 plus 3, 12. 12 plus 6, 18. You get 18. If you add this 4 number, you get 18. So, is 18 divisible by 3 or not? Yes, it is divisible. 18 is divisible by 3. 3 6 are 18. So, this number will be also be divisible by 3. So, like this way, we find the divisibility of 3. Now, let us find for the other number, that is 4. Let us check the divisibility of 4. We have to check whether the given number is divisible by 4 or not. So, what is the rule? If the number formed by the last two digits, the number which is forming by the last two digits is divisible by 4, then the given number will be divisible by the 4. Let us take the example 360 360. What are the last two digits? 60. The last two digits are 60. So 60 is divisible by 4. The 60 is divisible by 4. So this number is divisible by 4. Let us take another example. Let me take this example, 5463. What are the last two digits? 63. So 63 is not divisible by 4. So this number is not divisible by 4. Now let us take another number, that is we are taking 5. We have to check the divisibility of 5, whether the given number is divisible by 5 or not. So what is the rule? If the ones digit is 0 or 5, if at ones digit 0 or 5 is there, then the given number will be divisible by 5. Let us take an example, 360. What is there at the ones place? 0 is there. So what is written here? If at the ones place 0 or 5 is there, then the given number will be divisible by 5. So 360 will be divisible by 5. Let us take another example, 4363. Is this number divisible by 5 or not? How you will be checking it? At the ones place. At the ones place 3 is there. So this number will not be divisible. Let us take another example, 4365. See, at the ones place 5 is there. So this number will be divisible by 5. So without dividing, within second you can find out whether the given number will be divisible by 5 or not. You have to see only at the ones place. You have to see only at the ones place. If at the ones place 0 or 5 is there, then only the number will be divisible by 5. The next is 6. We have to check whether the given number is divisible by 6 or not. Then how will we be checking it, that whether the given number will be divisible by 6 or not? Let us see now. Let us take another number. Let me take 6 here. I have to check whether the given number is divisible by 6 or not. So what is the rule? If the number is divisible by both 2 and 3, then the number will be divisible by 6. Let us take an example. I am taking 360. This number is divisible by 2 and this number is also divisible by 3. So 360 will be divisible by 6 also. Now let us take another example. 9. I have to check whether the given number is divisible by 9 or not. So what is the rule? If the sum of the digit is divisible, if the sum of digits is divisible by 9. If the sum of the digits is divisible by 9, then the given number will be divisible by 9. Let us take an example, 360. If I add this 3 number, that is 3 plus 6 plus 0, I will be getting 9. So 9 is divisible by 9, so this number will be divisible by the 9. If you remember, the same rule was for the 3 also. The next is 10. How to check the divisibility of 10? If the given number, if any number is given and you have to check whether the number it is divisible by 10 or not. We have to check whether the number is divisible by 10 or not. So what is the rule? If at once digit 0 is there, then the given number will be divisible by 10. In 360, at the ones place 0 is there, so this number will be divisible by 10. Let us take another example, 465. Here at the ones place 5 is there, so this number will not be divisible by 10. Let us take some larger number, 5640. Here at the ones place 0 is there, so this number will be divisible by 10. The next is 15. How to check the divisibility of the 15? If the number is divisible, if the number is divisible by both 3 and 5, then the number will be divisible by 15 also. Let us take an example, 360. 360 was divisible by 3. Why? Because 3 plus 6 was 9. So this number was divisible by 3. And it was also divisible by 5. Why? Because at the ones place 0 is there. So it was divisible by 5 and 3, both the numbers, so it will be divisible by 15 also. This number will be divisible by 15 also. So let us do one problem now. We will be doing now one word problem related to the divisibility rule. You have to check the divisibility of, check the divisibility, we have to check the divisibility in the question. What we have to do, we have to check the divisibility of, I am writing the number, we have to check the divisibility of by 18. 11,718. We have to check whether this number is divisible by 18 or not. Students, if in the question, like the number it is given, in divisibility rule we have studied about 2, 3, 4, we have studied the smaller number. But what if in the question this larger number is there, like 18? So how you will be checking the divisibility? Whether 18 is this number will be divided by 18 or not. So how will be checking? First we have to think, first we have to think the co-prime factors of 18. Do you remember co-prime factors? What were the co-prime factors? Just again I am telling you, co-prime factors. co-prime factors, the example, with the help of the example, I will be explaining you. Co-prime factors are like 3 and 5, which has 1 as the common factor. Any two number which has 1 as the common factor, they are known as the co-prime factors. So what you have to do, you have to first find the co-prime factor of 18. You have to think two co-prime factors. If you multiply that two co-prime factor, the answer should come 18. And that two prime factors, co-prime factors, should have one common. So we have to think it. So what will be the two co-prime factors of 18? It will be 2 and 9. 2 and 9 are two co-prime factors of 18. How do I find the co-prime factor? Here in the rough I am explaining 18. Yes. 2 multiplied by 9 is equal to 18. Yes. So these are two co-prime factors of 18. You can say why? Because if you multiply this two number, that is 2 multiplied by 9 is equal to 18. So these two are the co-prime factors of 18. So you have to, how you will be checking whether the given number, this is divisible by 18 or not. If this number 11718 will, you have to check whether this number will be divisible by 18. 18, what are the co-prime factors of 18? 2 and 9. So you will be checking whether they are divisible by this two co-prime factors, that is 2 and 9. So this number 11718, at the ones place 8 is there. 8, it is the even number. So this number, it is divisible by 2. And whether this number is divisible by 9 or not, how will be checking it? 11718, you will be adding it. 1 plus 1 plus 7 plus 1 plus 8. You will be adding this, all this number. If you add this, you will be getting 18. So 18, it is divisible by 9. So this number, that is 11718, this number is divisible by both 2 and 9. So it will be also be divisible by 18. Again I am explaining, students, if in the question it is asked, check the divisibility, a larger number is given and you have to check the divisibility of it by 18. So we have checked the divisibility rule for the smaller number like 2, 3, 4, 5, 10. How to check for the 18? In order to check for the 18, first you have to find the co-prime factors of 18. Co-prime factors means one should be there as common factor. Like for 18, it is 2 and 9. If I multiply 2 multiplied by 9, it is 18. And this both the number, they are having 1 as their common factor. So now this number, if it is divisible by both 2 and 9, then it will be also be divisible by 18. So we know the divisibility rule to check for 2 and 9. Yes, how to check the divisibility by 2? If at the ones place here the even number is there, then it is divisible by 2. If you add all these numbers and the answer, that is 18, if it is divisible by 9, then this given number will also be divisible by 9. So this number, it is divisible by both 2 and 9. So it is divisible by 18 also. So that's all for today's class. Have a nice day.